mind is like a fertile land where ideas keep growing but fail to take proper shape in the absence of proper nurture and care. Once our co-founders, Mr. Amit Mishra and Mr. Shishir Miglani, understood this fact, they came together for Kidspreneur. We at Kidspreneur nurture mindsets and make them future ready by exposing young minds to hands-on management tools and tips, which in turn develops their leadership skills into the entrepreneurship abilities from a very young age. Here we have a very short video from Kidspreneur to make you understand a little more about them.
You may be surprised to know, kids' creativity peaks at the age of 5 and they can start to learn 5 foreign languages or more simultaneously at that age. NASA reports an average kid's creativity falls by almost 86% until adulthood. A young mind is like a fertile land where ideas keep growing but fail to take proper shape in absence of proper guidance. We, at Kidspreneur, nurture mindsets and make them future-ready by exposing young minds to hands-on management tools and tips, which in turn, develops their leadership skills into the entrepreneurship abilities, at a very young age. We implement simulation and real-time scenarios and gamify critical management lessons for effective learning. The entire activity is transformative to cultivate the thought process of becoming the future entrepreneur and employment creator. We skill, we test and we invest in teams with promising ideas without fear of failure, as we believe that we must prepare kids for failure and the success will follow. Creating thought leader for tomorrow. Find out more about us on kidspreneur.com or visit us on social networks.
A great initiative, as you all may think. Mr. Shishir Miglani has a vision to transform the future of education in ways not imagined before. Kidspreneur is just a start for him. He is the co-founder at Kidspreneur and we have him today with us. I welcome you, Mr. Shishir.
Thank you for the welcome, Aditi.
Most welcome, sir. We also have today with us Ms. Saloni. Ms. Saloni is an entrepreneur. She is an entrepreneur and business management coach with 30 years of industry experience in leadership consulting, coaching, mentoring, and training. Widely traveled, she has worked with people from different cultures and countries as the US, UK, Netherlands, France, Singapore, Japan, Hong Kong, Taiwan, Korea, Australia, and Afghanistan. A postgraduate in human resources, her credibility with business houses shines through her executive coaching, people development and management, and entrepreneurship skills. In 2012, she founded It's People, and in 2013, she was honored with the Best Business Plan Award at the 10K ISB Goldman Sachs Women Entrepreneurship Program. It's People is a boutique consulting and coaching firm that is focused on creating endless possibilities of growth for entrepreneurs and client organizations through a transformational organizational development framework and human resource tools and practices. Ms. Saloni has joined us today to discuss on the building up of a positive mindset for grabbing the future opportunity. We welcome you, ma'am.
Thank you so much for having me here.
So ma'am, we have some questions from the audience already that, you know, we eagerly want to know about. And also the questions that our people will be posting to us directly, we'll be, you know, fetching answers for them also from you. So the first question that we have is, what inspired you to the beginning of It's People?
So, you know, I started my career and I joined my dad's business. It's a family business, and I think my first decade of the experience that I had working in different business verticals the seeds of entrepreneurship were already there. However, I wanted to get into something which was more people development oriented, because that was something I was very passionate about, and I still am. And that's how It's People happened later on.
Okay, so that's great. So you've been coaching people on their business and personal management skills. What are the few things that people miss out on?
So if I were to look at professionals, I think, especially in these lockdown times when people are concerned about what's the future going to look like, or what should they really do with this time, then I would say that, if you want to really create impact and value for yourself, you have to do it for others. And to be able to do that, first you have to have that investment in yourself, which basically means that you need to work upon yourself. So whether it is lockdown or not, the best of the ROI, the return on investment that you make upon yourself as an individual, as a professional, as a leader, as a manager, that investment, building yourself up, building your skills, building yourself in the domain that you are, you know, pursuing, or the career track that you are working on, or the area in which you want to excel, building yourself on that specific track is going to help you create that impact in the marketplace. And that's the track that you should be taking up.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for the great insights. The other question that we have is, it's a very common question that parents want to seek answers to, especially. So in these days of quarantine, when all of us are locked inside our houses, how do you think can we keep ourselves motivated and have a positive mindset, especially for kids, because they can't even go out to play and meet their friends? So they are, you know, totally engrossed in technology and using laptops and phones the entire day. So how can we help them?
I believe the answer to that lies in the way your day is structured. What do you do with your day? How do you start your day? I also believe that the more powerful your day starts, right, that sets the tone for how the rest of the day is going to go. So, but if you want to like kind of wake up late and have a relaxed, probably a brunch, if not breakfast, then already, you know, that laziness not having an agenda or not having a plan of what you really want to do during the day puts you in a space where you feel not so much as inclined or not so much as ambitious or passionate about doing something in that day or achieving something significant in that day, leads to your not feeling at the end of the day that you have achieved something. So I always believe that if you start your day right, powerfully, and you have, if not a big plan, but you have a small plan that says some of the significant things that I'm going to do today, or you know, work on it today, whether it's a child or whether it's a parent, if they all have that agenda that this is what I want to do today, achieve today, accomplish today, and that gets done, then that is really good, because at least some progress is being made. And there's something that you can look back and say, okay, I did have a great day because I was able to do X, Y, Z.
But as adults, we can do this, you know, consciously. But the kids, for them, it's like vacation time. So how do we motivate them? If you could, you know, enlighten us a little more about keeping them on track.
Okay. Is it really vacation time, I'd like to ask?
Not for
I guess even they're having classes, even they have, because I know so many of my colleagues, you know, the classes start at right, sometimes at 9, sometimes at 10. And it goes on till lunch, and even sometimes thereafter, after 3 o'clock or so. And some of my friends who are also school teachers, I mean, they really have a schedule to look at. So I would say that it's a normal day. Now, this is kind of the new normal. So let's look at it, that if this was the new normal, what would you do? You would get up on time. You would go through the motions of the day because you have school to attend. And the only difference is now that you're doing it from your own bedroom or your own study room or your own dining or living room. And then you would have those slots. You know, you've segmented your day. You have slots where you are doing some extracurricular activities, depending upon what your hobbies are. Yes, you can't go out and play, but you know, and so can't we as parents, right? Even we can't go out and play. So what do we do? We've created some hobbies for ourselves. We created those special segments of durations of time for ourselves during the day, in which we are doing things like reading books. So if the child is interested to, you know, read books, then you know they should be, and you can go digital there too, right? It's a digital world anyways. If the child is interested in creating something, so maybe there are blocks and Legos that the child can use. If the child is very creative, right? I know of people and parents where the child is really good at singing and dancing, and they have launched their own YouTube channel. Now that's a great thing to do. And very innovative. So today, I think kids are very creative. and they just need the little trigger, just need a little push, and they are more technology savvy, I would say. Right? Today I was trying to figure out how to do these, you know, backdrops, and we realize that we can't do it because of this being a Mac. But I guess children know much more about technology these days than you know, their parents do, because they have been brought up in a digital world, and for them, taking on you know, lapping up digital ways of working and living is very easy for them, as opposed to, let's say, the elder generation. I hope that answers the question.
I would like to add something here, Saloni. I know Saloni for a while, and I think jab Saloni samjhati hai to everybody just listens to her. Kafi impressive hota hai. Aur abhi kyunki the context is around kids at home, and we are still stuck in quarantine at least until May 17 for now. So kehte hai ki jab adults are stuck at home, so even they behave like kids. So especially for a women's perspective and a housewife and a mother, there would be more than one kid to manage. How do you think patience plays a very important role here, or what kind of notes would you like to suggest which can really improve this kind of a scenario at home, where more kids can actually enjoy more? Or
I believe you know, people believe that we are going through difficult times. I believe that these are just different times, not difficult times. These are just different times. How do we make the best of this different time, especially as a mother or as parents? How do we make it different? How do we use these different times? Look at how do you actually bond with your children these days. Right? So earlier, kitna time milta tha aap logon ko apne bachchon ke saath time spend karne ke liye. Today, they are right there, and so are you. I know of instances where the family, kahte na family that stays together, plays together, eats together. So it's that old way of living and, you know, working that's come back. Playing with your kids, especially if the kids are small, playing with your kids. I have a dog and I play with him because my kids are not at home right now these days. So if I don't play with him, then he's like, play with me. And what are you doing? So the same way, the kids also want attention, and playing with the kids is great. You could be doing exercises together. You'd be doing yoga, or you could be dancing together. You could be doing, you know, playing, you know, board games together, and we have so many of them to choose from, whether it's Ludo or Carrom or whatever. More important is spending time with your kids to understand them and probably help them also identify. There's this very nice Japanese concept that I talk about most of the time when, you know, people ask me. It's called ikigai, which is basically, you know, life's purpose. And though we don't want to ask our children today, we do end up asking, what do you want to be when you grow up? The ikigai is a very nice tool to just understand and identify what are the great things that your child, you know, enjoys doing. What is he really passionate about? So what is he really good at, and what is he really passionate about? Because if you can identify those, and you can also speak to your child and ask him to make a list. Okay, what are the things that you'd like to do? So let's make a list. And as a parent, you can make your list. As a child, you can ask the child to make a list. And then you can say, okay, these are things that you like doing. Now imagine, you, some things would be there which will be news to you also, because you never realized your child wanted these 20 things, that he actually loved doing these 20 things. And you could also like kind of plan those entire 20 things, say, okay, is mahine ye cheeze honge, and probably have a calendar, probably have an engagement calendar. Where you could be using like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. You could be doing things like that to engage and bond with your children. And that should not only help you know your children, your kids better, but also help you understand what they are really good at. Because sometimes when you are so busy at work, you miss out on the moments when, you know, you see your child grow up, and you really miss out that this is something that he's really good at. So my congratulations to those parents who actually, you know, already know what their children are good at. And if you still don't know, then you can use these small, you know, techniques to bond and also identify the things.
Absolutely.
That
they are great at. Absolutely. Aditi, over to you.
Ma'am, those are very great insights. And I know, the parents are going to love these insights, and I am pretty sure that many of them are going to try these at home to know their kids better and make the best use of this quarantine time, which we hope should be, you know, short-lived. So we have another question for you from the audience. It is usually said that if you catch them early, you can teach them better. How do you think can parents try and understand their kids at small age and help them get into right profession later?
Yeah, exactly. Like I was saying that, you know, every child is unique and he is great at something which is just waiting to be discovered. You know, sometimes we are good at, really good at something, but it takes such a long time for us to even discover what are we really good at. You know, I'm not talking about the big thing like what is the purpose of my life, but when it comes to our children, you know, our children are very special. Each child is special, and there is that something in that child which makes him stand, you know, stand tall and stand different from others. And that's really what you got to find out. When as a parent, if you can get that early, you know, not just catch it, but get it early, the way you go about planning, the way you would go about, you know, envisioning what future your child can really create for himself, which he's too young at this moment to really envision it for himself. But as a parent, you can do that. You know, that will be such a great thing if you can do that. And that's why they say that if you catch them early, you have this thing that, oh, my son is really great. My daughter is really great at football, or my son is really great at dancing or singing or something which is really unique, that he has a way with the musical instruments, and he's able to probably, you know, very good at languages, you know. So if you are alert and you catch those waves, you know, those vibrations, and, you know, set it in the direction that's going to help your child really do well in life, because that's what he, not just you leveraging the greatness, the uniqueness in him, but you're also helping him, you know, move on that track.
I hope the parents follow this, you know, plan to find out what their kids are best at. Also, while, you know, trying to understand their kids, parents sometimes unknowingly pressurize their kids to study and compete in this world. How can we promote healthy studying, you know, so that the kids can give their best without being under pressure?
So, you know, I have raised two children, and I'm not a very traditional, I'm a very unconventional mom. I've never pressurized my kids that, though I will tell them that exams hai, aapko baith jao. Every parent will do that. But I don't pressurize kids, or I haven't done that for my own children. Because first of all, I'm not denying that the discipline needs to be there. It's also about what's the approach that you as a parent have taken to make sure that your child understands and is not just doing it because you're asking them to do it, but you're also inculcating in the child this level of responsibility for his life. So if as a small child, you would tell your kid that, okay, there's something that we need to buy from the market, and, you know, we have these three things, right? And we got to buy, let's say you want to make him all, make him value money. So how do you get something at a great cost, which means the minimal, and yet to get the best product, right? Now, until you expose your child to such scenarios and values, or you help them grow up, right? So most of the times parents kind of are protective. They do not tell children whatever their challenges are. But if you actually level up and actually help expose expose in a positive way, how do you give that exposure to children so that they're able to value that experience? And also, how do they then inculcate that value in their life? That depends, you know, on parents. So my children understand cost. They understand value, because I always used to ask them, you know, they understand value of time. I would tell them that, you know, once mama is back from office, and then you tell her that ye saman lana hai school ke liye, you know, this doesn't work because mama is tired. So you need to call me in the afternoon and tell me that this is the homework and this is the things that I need from the market. So mama, when you come back, can you get these? Because then I am also prepared. So this is time management. This is also, in a way, some emotional intelligence. You're building that intelligence in your children so that they also understand that, you know, they just can't open their mouth and things will, you know, drop from the heavens. You know, it will require effort and time. And you as a parent are, you know, equally vocal about it, you know, in a positive, in a nice way. So the kids understand. We think bachche nahi samjhenge, so hum batate nahi hain. But bachche sab samajhte hain. And wo cheeze bhi samajh jate hain aur absorb kar jate hain, which you can never imagine. So, you know, having this communication, these open lines of communication is very important for the children.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for telling us so many things and, you know, making us look at this quarantine in a different perspective. We really thank you for this, for making us understand that this is not a difficult situation, but a different situation which needs a routine again.
That's right. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Also, I would like to say that before we end today's session, I would like to introduce to all of you an initiative by Kids Life by Kidspreneur, which is an effort to help parents and kids alike to stay engaged constructively amid this unfortunate lockdown situation. These testing times under COVID-19 situation have created a vacuum and forced us to face times we had never dreamt of. Engaging kids has become quite an effort for forced to stay inside their homes 24/7. This initiative, like many others, may help you in keeping your child engaged.
That's wonderful.
It was very good to have you, Saloni. And we really love those insights. Some of them were coming very practical ones, and I'm sure a lot of parents and a lot of students, kids, I would say, they would understand each other better in those lines. And yes, communication has always been key in any two relationships. So that's going to play a long role. And we hope that you join our show again soon, sometime again, and we will share more about your insights to our viewers there. Thank you, Aditi.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, Shishil. It's a pleasure to be here on Kids Live. Look forward to many more sessions.